In decay of radioactive nucleus, we have seen two type of particles can be ejected out. One was helium nucleus, and that ejection we name it as alpha decay. In the second type of decay, it is an electron or a positron which is ejected out from the nucleus, and we call it beta decay. What are the changes we have seen in their mass numbers and in their charge numbers? Now, whenever there is a alpha decay or beta decay, from the mother nucleus a daughter nucleus is born and a particle is out. During this process, some energy is also released. That energy is released, and there are stages of that. First, when from mother nucleus there is a conversion to daughter nucleus, that is one thing. But that daughter nucleus at that particular moment initially is in excited state. Excited state means it has more than the normal energy which is associated, which should be associated with that daughter nucleus. So that, because of that additional energy it is having, it is known as in excited state. From that excited state, it wants to come to the level of its minimum energy that we call ground state. So what it does, it is ejecting out the energy packets, energy in packets, and that packet of the energy is known as gamma rays in the language of rays, or you can say gamma photon in the language of photons. Now that energy is out. When that energy is out, that is known as gamma decay. This is gamma decay of that radioactive process. Now we have one example, cobalt. Cobalt is a radioactive material, and with a beta decay, beta minus, if there is a minus decay, then this 27 will become 28, and when this 27 become 28, the name will change to nickel. So what is our process? Our process is cobalt 2760. There is an ejection of electrons, so naturally what remain here will be 2860, and 28, because of 28 we write the name nickel. So cobalt is converted into nickel, that is there, plus antineutrino, that is there. Now this nickel which is produced, it has different levels of energy. Initially when beta decay is there, then this nickel has got a large energy, and what we find, one photon ejects out, that is 1.17 million electron volt. This photon or gamma, this is radiated out, and that photon is having how much energy? 1.17. After that another photon comes out, and that photon has energy 1.33 million electron volt, and it is because of this energy we have given it the name of gamma, because we have made separate range of different energy carrying photons, and we have given them the name gamma rays, X-rays, and below that ultraviolet rays, then the visible rays, like that. So these are the photons of the gamma, because they carry such large amount of energy, million electron volt. You know, when the atom is excited and comes back to ground state, it also gives out energy which is in the range of electron volt. That is by the excitation of atom, and when the atom comes back to its ground state, that is in the range of electron volts, but here it is in million electron volts because it is nuclear reaction. Anyway, after that losing so much, what we observe, that we have found nickel, and this nickel is in ground state of energy. Ground state of energy. Here we have got the nickel here, nickel 28. But this is in excited state. From excited state, it gives out 2 photon and come back to ground state. This decay is known as gamma decay. So it is always followed by either beta decay or alpha decay. In both cases it happens. So the energy which we have calculated, which is ejected out, that is ejected out in the form of gamma rays. And why only gamma? Because the photon packets, we are carrying energy of a very high magnitude, and this high magnitude, we have given it a name, gamma. So it is gamma decay in this way. Thank you.